Hi everyone! Welcome again sa akin channel. For this video, ang ituturo ko sa inyo ay yung continuation ng Unit 4, which is all about exponential functions. The next lesson of Unit 4 is exponential equations as well as the solving of exponential equations. Let's start with the definition of exponential equation. An exponential equation is an equation having exponential expression or expressions. Recall that 2 raised to x, e raised to 2x, 1 half raised to 4x, or 0.08 raised to x are all exponential expressions. Hindi pa sila equation kasi wala pang equal sign at hindi sila equated sa isa't isa. The exponential expressions can be on the left side, right side, or both sides of the equations. Let's have examples. Number 1, 16 raised to negative x is equal to 1 over 64. Isa lang ang ating exponential expression, pero dahil siya ay equal sign, ito ay exponential equation. Number 2, we have 3 raised to x squared is equal to 9 raised to 2x minus 1. On both sides of the equation, meron tayong exponential expression, kaya ito ay exponential equation. Number 3, we have 2 raised to 2x minus 1 is equal to 4 raised to 3x plus 2. Meron ulit tayong exponential expression on both sides, kaya siya ay exponential equation. Then last, number 4, we have 2 raised to 2 times the quantity of 5 raised to x plus 1 is equal to 500. Meron lang ulit tayong isang exponential expression sa left, pero dahil siya ay equal sign, siya pa rin ay exponential equation. After knowing the definition and form of exponential equation, ang kasunod na niyan ay solving. So let's proceed on solving exponential equations. In order for us to solve exponential equations, we will use the laws of exponents. Recall that the laws of exponents are the following. Number 1, we have a raised to m times a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. Ang ibig sabihin nito is kapag meron tayong exponential expression na same base, at siya ay naka-multiplication, kukopyahin lang natin yung base and then i-add natin yung kanilang exponent. For example, we have 2 raised to x times 2 squared is equal to 2 raised to x plus 2. Kasi ang common base nila ay 2 at ang exponent ay x at saka 2 kapag ina-add x plus 2. Next, we have a raised to m over a raised to n is equal to a raised to m minus n. This time, ang operation naman is division. Kapag meron tayong exponential expression na same base, ang ginagawa natin sa exponent nila ay sinasubtract natin, m minus n. For example, we have 3 raised to 3x over 3 raised to x. That will be, kukopyahin natin yung base na 3, then isa-subtract natin yung exponent, 3x minus x. Dahil pwede pa natin isimplify ito, 3x minus x is 2x. Kaya ang final answer dyan is 3 raised to 2x. Next law, we have the quantity of a raised to m raised to n is equal to a raised to m times n. Ang ibig sabihin nito is kapag meron tayong exponential expression na naka-raise pa to another exponent, ang gagawin natin sa exponents ay imo-multiply. For example, we have the quantity of 4 raised to 2, then raised to x. Ang exponents natin ay 2 at saka x, imo-multiply natin, kaya magiging 4 raised to 2x. The next law of exponent is the quantity of a times b raised to m is equal to a raised to m times b raised to m. Ang ibig sabihin nito is kapag meron tayong quantity na nakamultiply, then naka-raise sila sa same exponent, i-distribute lang natin yung exponent sa kanilang dalawa. For example, the quantity of 5x raised to 2 is equal to, i-distribute natin yung exponent 2 sa 5 at sa x. Kaya magiging 5 raised to 2 times x raised to 2. Dahil pwede natin i-simplify ito, 5 squared is 25. Kaya ang answer dyan is 25x squared. The next law is the quantity of a over b raised to m is equal to a raised to m over b raised to m. Ang ibig sabihin nito is kapag meron tayong dalawang quantity na naka-fraction form or naka-division form, tapos naka-raise sila sa same exponent, i-distribute lang natin yung exponent sa kanilang dalawa. Example, the quantity of 6 over x raised to 3 will be, i-distribute natin yung 3 na exponent sa 6 at saka sa x, kaya 6 raised to 3 over x raised to 3. Dahil pwede natin i-simplify ito, the answer is 216 over x cubed. The next law is a raised to negative m is equal to 1 over a raised to positive m. Ang ibig sabihin nito is kapag meron tayong base na naka-raise sa negative exponent, ang gagawin natin para maging positive yung exponent, kukunin natin ang reciprocal. Kaya magiging 1 over a raised to m, positive na yung exponent. Example, 7 raised to negative x is equal to 1 over 7 raised to x. Dahil yung exponent natin na x ay negative, gagawin natin positive, kukunin natin ang reciprocal. So that is the laws of exponents that are very useful in order to solve exponential equations. Let's proceed on solving some examples. Example number 1. Solve the exponential equation 16 raised to negative x is equal to 1 over 64. Kung mapapansin natin, the equation have different bases, 16 and 64. What we're going to do is convert 16 and 64 to the same base. Ang common base nila ay 4, kaya ang 16 pwede natin gawing 4 squared, ang 64 naman ay pwede natin gawing 4 cubed, pero dahil ito ay 1 over 64, gagawin muna natin siyang 1 over 4 cubed, then saka natin gagawin 4 raised to negative 3 base sa ating negative exponent law. So papalitan ngayon natin yung 16 at yung 1 over 64. Ito ngayon ay magiging the quantity of 4 squared raised to negative x is equal to 4 raised to negative 3. And then, mapapansin natin na meron tayong expression na naka-raise pa sa exponent. Kaya, ia-apply natin yung rule na the quantity of a raised to m raised to n is equal to a raised to m times n. So, itong 2, imultiply natin sa negative x. Kaya siya magiging 4 raised to negative 2x is equal to 4 raised to negative 3. So, dahil same base na sila, ang gagawin natin sa base is we're going to cancel the bases and then equate the exponents. Ang exponents natin ay negative 2x at negative 3. So we have negative 2x is equal to negative 3. And then solve for the value of x. Para makuha natin yung value of x, we're going to divide both sides by negative 2. And then the answer will be negative 3 over negative 2 is positive 3 over 2. Bago natin i-box yung ating final answer, ay i-check muna natin yung 3 over 2. Pag sinubstitute natin dito sa negative 3 over 2, the answer will be 1 over 64. If that is the case, then 3 over 2 is a solution. Let's have example number 2. Example number 2. Solve the exponential equation 2 raised to 2x minus 1 is equal to 4 raised to 3x plus 2. Again, the equation have different bases, that is 2 and 4. What we're going to do is convert 2 and 4 to same base. Ang common base nila ay 2. Yung 2 natin ay 2 raised to 1. And then yung 4 ay pwede natin palitan ng 2 raised to 2. So dahil ito ay 2 raised to 1, mananatili siyang 2 raised to 2x minus 1. Pero yung right side natin, yung 4 ay papalitan natin ng the quantity of 2 squared, then naka-raise pa siya sa 3x plus 2. Mapapansin natin na meron ulit ang expression na naka-raise pa sa exponent. Kaya i-apply ulit natin yung law na the quantity of a raised to m raised to n is equal to a raised to m times n. So what we're going to do is i-multiply natin itong 2 sa quantity ng 3x plus 2. Kaya ang next line of solution is 2 raised to 2x minus 1 is equal to 2 raised to 2 times the quantity of 3x plus 2. Dahil same base na tayo, we're going to cancel the bases and equate the exponents. Ang ating exponents ay 2x minus 1 is equal to 2 times the quantity of 3x plus 2. And then, we're going to solve for the value of x. I-distribute muna natin yung 2 sa 3x plus 2. Ito ay 2 times 3x, 6x, at 2 times 2 is 4. Kaya, 2x minus 1 is equal to 6x plus 4. Then, combine like terms to solve for the value of x. Kaya magiging negative 1 minus 4 is equal to 6x minus 2x. And then, simplify. Negative 1 minus 4 is negative 5. Then, 6x minus 2x is 4x. And then, divide both sides by 4. Kaya, ang value ng x is negative 5 over 4. Again, bago natin siya i-box, ay i-check muna natin. It will satisfy the equation. Then, this is a solution. Let's have one more example. Example number 3. Solve the exponential equation 3 raised to x squared is equal to 9 raised to 2x minus 1. Again, ang ating equation have different bases, 3 at saka 9. What we're going to do is convert 3 and 9 to same base. Ang 3 ay katumbas ng 3 raised to 1 at ang 9 naman is pwedeng 3 squared. So papalitan ngayon natin yung 9 ng 3 squared. Pero yung 3 as is na siya na 3 raised to x squared. 3 raised to x squared is equal to the quantity of 3 squared raised to 2x minus 1. Again, meron tayong expression na naka-raise pa sa another exponent. Kaya i-apply ulit natin yung rule na the quantity of a raised to m raised to n is equal to a raised to m times n. So what we're going to do ay yung 2 na exponent i-multiply natin sa quantity ng 2x minus 1. Kaya we have 3 raised to x squared is equal to 3 raised to 2 times the quantity of 2x minus 1. Dahil same base na tayo, so what we're going to do is cancel the bases, then equate the exponents. Ang ating mga exponents ay x squared is equal to 2 times the quantity of 2x minus 1. And then, we're going to solve for the value of x. I-distribute muna natin yung 2. 2 times 2x is 4x. Then, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. So, we have x squared is equal to 4x minus 2. Also, mapapansin natin na meron tayong x squared. Kaya, ang pwedeng mabuong equation dito is quadratic equation. Pag sama-samahin natin, sa left side, lahat ng terms. X squared minus 4x plus 2 is equal to 0. Then, continue to solve for the value of x. Meron tayong tatlong method sa pagsasolve ng quadratic equation. Una is kapag kaya siya ng factoring. Pangalawa is pwede siya ng completing the square. At pangatlo is quadratic formula. On our example, hindi siya pwede ng factoring. Kaya pwede natin gamitin yung quadratic formula. Ang ating quadratic formula is negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Ang ating a is 1, ang ating b ay negative 4, at ang ating c is positive 2. I-substitute natin yung value sa ating quadratic formula. we have negative of negative 4 plus or minus the square root of negative 4 squared minus 4 times 1 times 2 all over 2 times 1. Ang simplification nito, direct computation, is x is equal to 2 plus or minus square root of 2. Therefore, meron tayong dalawang possible answer. X sub 1 is 2 plus the square root of 2, and x sub 2 is equal to 2 minus square root of 2. Bago natin i-box ang final answer, ay i-check muna natin yung dalawang values sa original equation kung magsasatisfy siya na equal. If they satisfy the equation, then these two values are solution. Let's have one more example. Example number 4, solve the exponential equation. The quantity of 1 over 125 raised to 2x minus 2 times 625 raised to x is equal to 125. Again, the equation have different bases. We have 125 and 625. What we're going to do is convert 125 and 625 into same base. Ang common base nila ay 5. Ang 125 ay equivalent ng 5 cubed. Ang 625 naman ay equivalent ng 5 raised to 4. Pero dahil meron tayong 1 over 125, i-convert muna natin siya into 1 over 5 cubed bago natin gawing 5 raised to negative 3 using the negative exponent law. So ito ngayong 1 over 125 ay papalitan natin ng 5 raised to negative 3. Ang 625 ay magiging 5 raised to 4 at ang 125 ay 5 cubed. We have the quantity of 5 raised to negative 3 raised to 2x minus 2 times 5 raised to 4 raised to x is equal to 5 cubed. On this part is meron tayong expression na naka-raise pa sa exponent. Kaya i-apply pa rin natin yung law na the quantity of a raised to m then raised to n is equal to a raised to m times n. Itong negative 3 na exponent, i-multiply natin sa quantity na 2x minus 2 at yung exponent na 4 ay i-multiply natin sa x. We have 5 raised to negative 3 times the quantity of 2x minus 2 times 5 raised to 4x is equal to 5 cubed. On this part, hindi pa tayo pwedeng mag-cancel ng mga bases kasi hindi pa single expression sa left at single expression sa kanan. Makikita natin na meron pa tayong operation na multiplication. Kaya ang i-apply natin dito ay yung rule na a raised to m times a raised to n is equal to a raised to m plus n. Ito yung ating a raised to m, ito yung ating a raised to n. Ang mga exponent ay ito, i-add natin sila, then copy the common base of 5. We have 5 raised to negative 3 times 2x minus 2, then plus 4x is equal to 5 cubed. Dahil single expression na sa left side at sa right side, saka pa lang natin i-apply yung cancellation of bases. Cancel the bases, then equate the exponents. Ang ating exponents ay negative 3 times the quantity of 2x minus 2 plus 4x is equal to 3. Then, solve for the value of x. I-distribute muna natin itong negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. Then, negative 3 times negative 2 is positive 6. We have negative 6x plus 6 plus 4x is equal to 3. Then, continue to simplify and solve for the value of x. Itong negative 6 at positive 4x ay combine natin, ang magiging sagot is negative 2x, while yung positive 6 ay i-transpose natin para makombine sa positive 3. So we have negative 2x is equal to 3 minus 6. Ang 3 minus 6 is negative 3. To get the value of x, divide both sides by negative 2. Therefore, x is equal to negative 3 over negative 2, which is positive 3 over positive 2. Bago natin i-box ulit yung final answer, i-substitute muna natin yung 3 over 2 sa value of x sa original equation. If it satisfies the equation, then this is a solution.